Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Looking for one of them hashtags that people use, you know, like Man Crush Mondays, you know, Woman Crush Wednesdays or whatever. So I've officially turned my Tuesday into Thirst Trap Tuesdays. Yes, to all the thirst trappers out there, this one is for you. I'm taking the time out to appreciate every thirst trapper out there, because y'all is life. You give us so much life. You know how beautiful it feels to see someone put up a thirst trap and you're like, I see you, daddy. But you can touch. So I'm dedicating this day to every thirst trapper out there. It doesn't matter if you're a chick or a... Wait, do they call chicks thirst traps too? Is this a guy? Who cares? This day is yours. No, wait. I actually started the day off, but I wanted to say it was Thirst Trap Tuesdays. But the biggest number of people I want to dedicate this day to are all the men out there who own sweatpants. Ooh. Child! Woo! If you own a pair of sweatpants, you're a dude, and you have mastered the art of no underwear in your sweatpants. This day is for you. Other than that, my name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop, your daily dose of gossip. Proudly sponsored by Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. Now let's delve into sipping some tea, stirring it, drinking it, pouring it, whichever it is. Let's get it. This whole Jeff Chua and Chosen Blood situation, it escalated for me in a certain way. So yesterday I ran the story, I told you what did go down, but we didn't have the exact details of what went down. So we hollered at Chosen, he finally picked up, and he gave us his side of the story. And what's baffling me here, Jeff, how old is Jeff Chua? Jeff, I name him. Mukuru Siwa Joe. And how old is Chosen Blood? Like, I'm trying to understand where or what happens in Jeff Chiwa's mind. I'm just trying to figure it out. Because yesterday I was like, Oba Gaiba Mwa Yiriza. Oba, you know? One of those. Because everyone always picks on Jeff Chiwa. I was like, no, maybe this is not one of them. But according to Chosen Blood, he says he had his posse with him, he had his crew with him. And Jeff and crew waited for his team to leave, because then they knew he would have no backup. The whole drama started because he was kagaye baka isani yarine arafa arafa na agenda. If someone basically tells you, you know what, I think this is for me, not working, I'm going to move on and I wish you luck, let me move on and do my thing, and you feel offended that he has left you. But what makes it worse is that you make it petty enough that, why, since you left me, they shouldn't even play your music if I'm at that bar. I'm like, Jeff Chiwa, Tokoye, Jeff Tokoye, Tokoye dinyaliokubera maulire for all the wrong things, Tokoye. Now everybody's going to blame it on alcohol. Na hiza katika njogere bulungi. Chiwa, Tokoye, toli musajja wajo, oli musajja mukulu. Tokowa, wea guwa kuba abantu, mungo bagamba mwe mulongo, mungo bagamba mbuyari abantu. That's the question. No. There times nina nendogo zeno industry. Waliwaya juku na mida. Narioka sule dogo mu industry. Ngeri muli ino gwisaka abantu abamwe daru. Because I don't understand it. And what's really sad is that at first I thought it was something small. Now, but while you're getting it chosen, you could hear it in his voice that he's also still baffled and scared for his life. And when he was finishing the call, he's like, Bana, movie that, yes, sitting at Namukola. I thought I was living in peace, you know? I was living in peace and moving on to other things. But clearly, if anything happens to me, Uchimanye yoyo. Kati gwe Jeffu. Obiko wade. Olwa notia nakana kebaza alanga gwe baku zale miaka mchinane mabe. Go chukolo otia.
Kana angechatu sewo. Baku vyo limba lande mindongo. Abantu nebasa nyuka. Omontu na veri. Nangu wa mbulago. Manager wa team nosi. Kuna linkula na Jeff Chiwa. Gusta ina kwa vizivu. Wese kumanga. Kuna abantu wana madiwa laba interviews. Ama kupayo na mbavira. Nkola biange. Ni yafudeni na nguo mbulago na nsindi kane ngweli out of blue, na vile mundi kumuna kwata mpula kwa wala wengkuli na mpeini, na nsindike ina yuza nisati, nilinga sina che mukoze.
Ah, Kanye and Kim were at the White House with, you know, our president. Y'all have seen the photos and some of the videos. And I like how Mseveni, my president, is like, wait, these are your shoes. Are they for football? Are they? Your company makes them. Oh, very nice, very nice. I was like, who brought Kanye West to the first house and did not explain or give the president a rundown of who the hell was coming to see him? Because then they would have given him the specs. They're like, well, this is Mr. Kanye West. And yes, he makes Yeezys and clothes that shouldn't even be given to the lowest of humans, but very expensive. And he's married to Kim Kardashian, whose only claim to fame was the fact that she was banged by Ray J and it went viral. And she took that and built an empire. But then again, like so many emotions, according to me, there's so many mixed emotions with this whole thing. Now let's talk about their outfits. Ah, the double standards in this country will be the death of us. So y'all remember when our president said, hoodies, no, we do not do hoodies at all. Truthfully, they were banned. Mr. West was in that building with a cape and a hoodie on. As in, how much more inconspicuous can you be? Cape, hoodie, all bundled up. And he was wearing, of course, his custom-made ugly Yeezys. Why? Anyway, it's like an iPhone. People don't buy iPhones because they love them. It's like a standard class thing, like Nimueno Kidas. And then our president got a pair of Yeezys that I know Muhozi is definitely going to be rocking, or one of those grandkids. Wait, zituka bebe. Bebe kendo chime Yeezys eba wade sevo. Other than that, but they were, but they can't. Next thing you know is Donald Trump is going to come to Uganda. Tweeting like a nonsense. And just being himself, just being Donald, Donnie. Has Donald Trump ever reminded you of Daffy the Duck? He does, to me. He does remind me of that. But hey, who am I to say anything? That's what's going on. And then, did you see that photo? What in the world of Nancha was our first son thinking posing with Kanye West like that? He was like this. He reminded me of Mr. Pickfair. Oh, yo, please, even if you're an army man, you're allowed to be at ease. He reminded me, honestly, he did. He did remind me of Mr. Pickfair. Anita right now must be seated somewhere with a pad. Like, wait, what did she wear? Mm-hmm. How did she talk? Okay. Wait, was that a ponytail or an extension? Okay. She is taking major notes, bitch. And all the other random slave queens, like, oh my god. Ha! Zari! Zari alimu Kampala. Zari ngakuze mye. Those are her role models. Zari is a wannabe of Kim Kardashian. She's like, okay, for me, Zari is a wannabe of Kim K and J-Lo. Like, if Kim K and J-Lo had a baby in case they were different sex, they would give birth to a Zari. I think she's also somewhere with a writing pad right now. Take notes, missions, take notes. Take notes, missions. Mutugambire ku Jennifer, Kindezo Kambwe. Oh, I'm jamming to that song right now simply because it has Jennifer Musisi in it. Yes, it went viral. She handed in her resignation. And then the reaction started to pour in. I'm like, you know what? You've done your time, Jenny. Like, let's take a moment and appreciate. She messed up a lot of things, but she also made some good things. So let's take a moment as Ugandans and give a big round of applause. Kudos. But my question though is, are they hiring? Because it seems after Jennifer has left, which other person is going to fill that position? Who has hips like hers? Who has a body like hers? The only reason we could never really get mad at Jennifer Musisi, even when she would do the worst things, it's because of what she looked like. Oh well, I'm so proud of her, you know. That's what they call winning. That's a woman with goals. That's a woman with the right attitude towards life. And I'm just going to take a minute, big her up. You done did your thing. I pray. The next person they bring. Anyway. Behavior, we're used to Alan Kajina. Then they brought for us Doris, and we sailed through. We'll sail through this KCCA thing too. Other than that, that's been what's going on. My name is Atina Fierce One. On Twitter, you can get me at Atina Fierce One. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and Atina Fierce One. Like, follow the pages. On Instagram, it's Atina Fierce One with an H. I'm out. Catch you again tomorrow.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habbo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.